blacksmith's forge. A well-dressed man, his name's George. Say good morning, Smithy, just the man I want to see. My daughter's pony threw a shoe. I was advised to come to you. And if you could replace it, I'll gladly pay your fee. His daughter brought the pony in. The blacksmith's eyes could not take in the beauty of the lady standing by the door. And when she smiled and said hello, deep in his heart he felt the glow. That day on, the blacksmith's life changed forevermore. Her daddy was a wealthy man, oh, many acres of fine land, 22-room mansion with a panoramic view. I've heard it said that love is blind. He couldn't change his daughter's mind. She fell in love with the blacksmith and made her pony shoe. On the day that they were married, she rode in a horse-drawn carriage. Four high-stepping ponies, two were black and two were gray. With seats of satin lining and buckles that were shining, they couldn't match her beauty on her wedding day. Right. Now you've heard the story of the blacksmith and the lady. Some may think it's fiction, some may think it's true. But I've never been to a wedding yet. Among the gifts the bride will get, someone will always give her a lucky old horseshoe. Her daddy was a wealthy man, many acres of fine land, 22-room mansion with a panoramic view. I've heard it said that love is blind. He couldn't change his daughter's mind. She fell in love with the blacksmith who made her a pony shoe. Whoa. Her daddy was a wealthy man, oh, many acres of fine land, 22-room mansion with a panoramic view. I've heard it said that love is blind. He couldn't change his daughter's mind. She fell in love with the blacksmith who made her pony shoe. Yeah, I've heard it said that love is blind. He couldn't change his daughter's mind. She fell in love with the blacksmith who made her pony shoe.